So this Krishna consciousness movement is very simple, very simple. It is inaugurated by Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu especially, although it is very old, the Vedic scripture, but it's still taking from the historical point of view. This Krishna consciousness movement is, since Lord Krishna appeared on the surface of this planet 5,000 years ago, and later on, Lord Chaitanya, 500 years ago, he expanded that movement of Krishna consciousness. His mission, Lord Chaitanya's mission, is Aradhya Bhagavan Vrajasasthana. If you want to love, if you want to be subordinate, everyone is subordinate. This is false. Everyone wants to be independent, but nobody is independent. Everyone is subordinate. Nobody can say that I am independent. Can you say, any one of you, that you are independent? Is there anybody?
No.
Everyone is subordinate, willingly, not by force. Everyone becomes subordinate. The girls say to the boy, I want to become your subordinate, willing. Similarly, boy says to a girl, I want to be a subordinate. Why? That is my nature. I want to be subordinate. Because my nature is to be subordinate. But I do not know. I reject this subordination, I accept another subordination. A subordination is there. Just like a worker. He works here, he finds some better wages, another place. He goes there. But that does not mean he becomes independent. He is subordinate. So, Lord Chaitanya teaches that if you want to be subordinate, or if you want to worship somebody, who worships somebody? Unless you feel somebody is greater than you, why shall you worship? I worship my boss because I think that he is greater than me. He gives me wages, salary, monthly, $600. Therefore, I must worship him, I must need him. So, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said that you become subordinate of Krishna. Aradhya Bhagavan Vrajasasthana. If you want to worship Krishna. And next, Tadhyama Vrindavanam. If you want to worship somebody, then love Krishna, worship Krishna, or his place, Vrindavan. Because everyone wants to love some place. That is now nationalism, some country. Somebody says, I love this American land. Somebody says, I love this Chinese land. Somebody says, I love the Russian land. So everyone wants to love some land. Bhomaijadhi. Bhomaijadhi. People are naturally inclined to love some material man. Generally, where he is born, he tries to love. The Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says that because you are inclined to love some person, you love Krishna. Because you want to love some land, you love Vrindavan. Aradha Bhagavan Vidasatanaya Stadhyama Vrindavan. But if somebody says, how to love Krishna? I cannot see Krishna. How to love Krishna? Then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, Ramya Kasi Upasana Vrajavadhu Bhargavi Kavita. If you want to learn, if you want to know the process of worshipping Krishna, loving Krishna, just try to follow the footprints of the gopis. Gopis. The gopis then love the highest perfectional love. Ramya Kati Upasana. There are different kinds of love or worship in the world. The beginning is, O God, give us our daily bread. This is the beginning. When we taught to love God, that we are instructed that we go to temple, go to church and pray to God for your necessities, for your grievances, that is the beginning. But that is not pure love. The pure love, perfection of pure love, can be found among the gopis. That is the example. How they love Krishna? They love Krishna. Krishna was a cowherd's boy. With his friends, other cowherd's boy, he used to go with his cows in the pasturing ground the whole day. That was the system. Because people at that time were satisfied with land and cows, that's all. That is the means of solution of all economic problems. They are not industrial, they are not servant of anyone, simply get production from the land and take milk from the cows, the whole food problem solved.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna,